Take a look at this map, which shows all known volcanoes in Hawaii. If you look right here, you'll see Kilauea. Slightly to the left is Mauna Loa. Move further right, and there's Mauna Kea and Hualalai on Big Island. Well, Mount Haleakala is located a little further up on Maui. At first glance, this looks like a map that shows a lot of volcanoes. But this isn't the only thing here. This small island here doesn't just house any volcanoes. It is home to five of the world's most dangerous volcanoes that might wipe out entire populations with a single eruption. According to most scientists, these are volcanoes that could bring forth the apocalypse with heat, fumes, and debris that they could give off with a single explosion. If that wasn't enough reason for you to be terrified, stick around to the end of this video to find out if the Mariana Trench is the only thing that you should be scared of. A group of seismologists have recently discovered a massive underwater volcano which is more than 3,500 meters below Mayotte. Statistics reveal that this new volcano has enough ammunition to effectively wipe humanity off the face of the Earth. Despite being underwater, the kind of power that this volcano holds is unimaginable. With all the shocking findings that have recently been accumulated after years of extensive studies, the scientists want to make sure that we are well prepared for when it does erupt. However, before we get into crisis mode, let's shed light into how this terrifying discovery was made, and why we should all be worried. What makes an underwater volcano so dangerous? Let's face it, a great majority of us never even knew that underwater volcanoes were a thing. While these volcano openings are submerged, they are obviously pretty hard to locate. Statistically speaking, most volcanic activities in the world occur under the sea level, while almost two-thirds of it occur in the deep sea. But the question remains, how are these volcanoes actually formed? Technically, there's no difference between how land and oceanic volcanoes are formed. Just like the volcanoes on land, underwater volcanoes come into existence when molten rock is produced in the second layer of the Earth's interior and shoots out of the crust. This molten rock solidifies and creates the volcano. Now, what exactly happens when an underwater volcano erupts? To get an idea of what an underwater volcano eruption looks like, we have to look no further than 2021, when the Hunga Tonga Hunga Haapai erupted. Scientists first began seeing signs of the extensive chaos on December 20th. About 4 weeks later, on January 15th, the volcano finally erupted, causing devastation throughout the region. The eruption was so devastating that it caused mass-scale destruction, something that we had never seen before. The eruption sent plumes of volcanic ash and magma soaring through the atmosphere, triggering massive tsunamis throughout the Pacific Rim, in regions such as Tonga, Fiji, American Samoa, and Vanuatu. Several areas in New Zealand, Japan, the United States, Russia, Chile, and Peru also experienced mini-tsunamis. The waves rose more than 60 feet high and tore through everything that came in their path. This was easily the worst volcanic eruption since the Mount Pinatubo disaster in the year 1991. By the end of it all, NASA concluded that the eruption was hundreds of times more powerful than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. Underwater volcanoes rarely erupt through the ocean's surface. This is because the pressure of the overlaying water prevents gas bubbles from forming and growing with explosive force. However, the volcanic vent that erupted on the 15th of January was only 250 meters deep. That's shallow enough that the water doesn't weaken the eruption's intensity, but deep enough for the magma to mix with water. But what does magma mixing with water have to do with the destruction caused that day? Well, let's explain. The impact of an underwater volcano eruption depends on the explosion's proximity to the water's surface. If the eruption happens really deep, then the weight of the overlying water dampens the pressure. For example, if magma is shot into the ocean about 5,000 feet below the surface, then it will have a lot of time to cool down. And since it's too deep, it might get really hot, but it won't turn into steam. But the circumstances are extremely different in shallow waters. Here, as soon as the magma starts to heat the water, it turns into steam and triggers a massive explosion of energy into the atmosphere. But scientists believe that the eruption of Hunga Tonga is just the tip of the iceberg, and the worst is yet to come. Back in 2018, a massive underwater eruption gave birth to a skyscraper-sized volcano. Scientists discovered the 2,690-foot-tall structure while studying a number of powerful earthquakes that struck near what is usually a seismically quiet area in the western Indian Ocean. After gathering geological data, the team realized that these earthquakes had produced a new submarine volcano. According to reports, a volcano of this size has never been found before. It is estimated to be 1.5 times the height of New York's World Trade Center. and originates from the deepest volcanic magma reservoir known to scientists. According to marine geoscientist Natalie Fuhrer, the reservoir is very deep. It's about 34 miles or 55 kilometers below ground level, and was the first time in volcanology that they could see such a deep reservoir at the base of the lithosphere. Now, this is where things start to get really scary. According to researcher Torsten Dahm, this volcano won't stop here. It's very likely that the volcano will continue to grow in size as the crust beneath it keeps on collapsing. If a volcano of this size erupts, we could be looking at a major crisis. Aside from the risk of tsunamis, the huge amount of ash ejected into the air will cause serious damage to our health. The ash and volcanic gases can also pollute the surroundings, making it almost impossible for life to survive. And let's not forget about the number of fumes and gases that will be released into the atmosphere, which will make it difficult for people to breathe. In addition to all of this, there's always the risk of volcanic ash accumulating in the atmosphere and completely blocking sunlight from reaching the Earth. The last time a similar-sized volcano erupted was 250 million years ago, when a supervolcano wiped out more than 75% of all life on Earth. The explosion was so powerful that it split North America and Africa apart, forming the Atlantic Ocean. While the Hunga Tonga eruption only lasted for 11 hours, this volcano kept spewing magma over and over for more than 600,000 years. But lava is only the first part of the problem. Depending on the size of the eruption, volcanic ash can cover the entire atmosphere, blocking sunlight and making it unbearably cold. Most of humanity would be dead by this point, but even if some people do manage to survive the volcanic ash, the rising CO2 levels will make it impossible to breathe and choke them to death. Now, what are the chances of a supervolcano actually erupting? A lot of people seem to think that the fear surrounding supervolcanoes is just a case of mass hysteria, but they're overlooking one simple fact. All that magma brewing deep inside the Earth has to come out someday. According to researchers, Yellowstone is the most likely supervolcano that could boil over at any moment. Historically, this volcano has erupted every 600,000 to 700,000 years. Having said that, take a guess as to when the last eruption took place. Well, it was 640,000 years ago. So, going by the numbers, Yellowstone could explode before you even finish watching this video. And if that's true, it could be the end of life on Earth as we know it. If the supervolcano erupted right now, places like Montana, Idaho, and Wyoming would be the first to crumble. Hazardous volcanic ash would engulf a third of the United States, rendering it uninhabitable for months, if not years. This would be followed by a series of earthquakes all over the country. The seismic activity would also activate other volcanoes around the world, and, well, you know what happens next. And for the recently discovered submarine volcano? Well, there seems to be no activity that would make us think it's erupting anytime soon. But if this volcano does explode under the ocean, you can definitely expect large-scale devastation. With all of this talk about destruction and chaos, we know you must be a little worried about what to do if a volcano erupts. According to most sources, the best course of action would be to immediately evacuate if you live around the volcanic area to avoid the initial fallout. If you are unable to evacuate, you should remain indoors with doors, windows, and ventilation shut until the ash settles. Have survival and cleanup resources such as dust masks, extra medication, plastic sheeting, and heavy-duty tape on hand so that you can live safely during the volcanic fallout. If you can somehow manage to pull through the first couple of weeks, you should be out of any immediate danger, making your chances of survival dramatically higher. With that said, what is your take on a supervolcano that might be erupting soon? Let us know in the comments down below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.